the project I'm working on today while I'm waiting for painted parts to come back is to add a Homelink auto dim rear view mirror to the MX-5. It has the same attachment as for the Mazda. This came out of a 2006 Nissan Maxima. And I grabbed a chunk of the harness too, so I'd have the plug. Now in general, auto dimming rear view mirrors should have a ground wire, a 12 volt constant, a 12 volt switched power, and a 12 volt power for when the car is put in reverse to shut off the mirror. So you should have four wires at minimum. So in this case, I've got 3, 4, 5. So in looking on the forums and online, when I put in the part number 453, I was having a hard time finding a pinout that matched this. So I was able to piece together from four or five different places that the black one is ground, which that one's pretty obvious, but it's in a different pin location than pretty much everywhere said it should be. And from what I found, the blue one and the brown one are extra. So I never found out exactly what they went to, but they either go to temperature sensors in case you have a mirror with a compass and a temperature display, or one of those is for the 12 volt reverse, which I'm not going to worry about. So that leaves two powers. One of these is for 12 volt constant, and one of them is for 12 volt switch power. So we'll roll this up so I don't get it confused, because the brown looks almost the same color as the other one. If I take the ground and connect it to our 12 volt battery, and then take one of these, so the Homelink should run off of the 12 volt constant, and the rear view mirror should run off of the 12 volt switch power. That you don't want that to run all the time. So let's try the brown one first and see what that lights up. So when we do that, you can see that the rear view mirror goes black and we've got a green power light. The brown wire seems to be our 12 volt switch power. So if I take that off, the mirror should go back to clear. And there it goes slowly. And if I add the black wire and push one of the Homelink buttons, you can see that it flashes red. The mirror seems to work. And if I add the brown one back, we should have both working. The mirror goes dim, and if I take my flashlight, you can see that the auto-dimming is working. So the auto-dimming is on, and if I push the Homelink buttons, they go red. And then if we hit power off, the green light goes out, and the mirror should go back to non-auto-dimming, and you can see reflection in it. So now that we've checked out the mirror, can go ahead and start installing it, which there are several YouTube videos on adding the rearview mirrors to the MX-5, so you should be able to figure that out pretty easily, but I'll just do kind of a quick demonstration as I put it in. Here's where we are now. Got the trim out and the header panel out. And looking on the forums, it appears that fuse number 5 is the switch power. And I'm going to change up from what I said before. I'm not going to put the Homelink on 12 volt constant power. I'm going to put it on switched power just because I tend to forget to lock the car when it's in the driveway, and if somebody comes by and just opens the door, they can open the garage door. So I'm going to keep that on switch power. And went over to the parts store and grabbed an Adalink. So let's go ahead and get it wrapped up. Got it roughed in, and I just powered the car on, and the mirror comes on, the home link's working, so I ran the harness as far over as I could, and then I put the 12 volt switched and the 12 volt constant into one connector and ran that down to constant 12 volts. Like I said, switched 12 volts. So that way the mirror and the home link will only work when the car is on. And then I ran the ground down to the fuse box. I probably could have put it somewhere along the header, but I just ran it down to the fuse box anyway. So once this, I'll wrap this all up in tape and tuck it behind the A-pillar and down behind the dash. And you can see the Adalink down here. So I used another one of the heat shrinking solder connectors. Those work really well. Use that there, and I had to use a crimp connector for the ground, but I took the plastic, so it has a yellow plastic jacket on it. I took that off and put some heat shrink tube on it instead. I prefer to do it that way. Everything seems to be working. I'll go ahead and button this up and put everything back together and should have a fully functioning rearview mirror. Alright, I've got everything buttoned up, the wires wrapped up and cable tied and tucked up under the header trim. Everything still works. Home link's working, the mirror on and off. Everything tucked up nicely behind the trim. So there's nothing to see. Looks factory. And yes, I know the mirror is dirty. I'll clean that when I detail the rest of the car, which is filthy. So the mirror was $9.50 from the junkyard with the chunk of harness and plug. The fusible link was about $8 from AutoZone. For less than $20 all in, I've got a working home link mirror, and it took maybe an hour to install. Now some of the other extra stuff like the connectors and the tape and that kind of stuff I already had, but yeah, for pretty much $20 you can put one of these mirrors in if you go to the pull apart. If you go to eBay, I think the mirrors are like $50.